Hello students, welcome back to Let Us Master English. Today we are going to learn how to write analytical paragraph when you are given a bar graph as input. Students, this question appears in the writing section of class 10 for 5 marks and is the task 1 of IELTS academic training. Students, you need too much practice in writing analytical paragraph as this is a new topic for you. And I'm sure by the end of the video, you will be able to write a good analytical paragraph on your own as the language and vocabulary required for writing analytical paragraph has been provided to you in this video along with all the tips and tricks. And as usual, there is going to be a homework for you at the end of the video because I know my students love doing homework. So let's get started. Students, in your writing section, you have two topics. One is formal letter based on a given situation, and you will be given two questions out of which you have to attempt any one. This is for 5 marks. And the second topic is writing an analytical paragraph based on given outline, data, chart or cues. Here also, you will be given two questions out of which you have to attempt any one. And this question too will be for 5 marks. Earlier, CBSE has announced that analytical paragraph is for 10 marks. But students, now there is a recent change. Now it is for 5 marks. Let us see what is analytical paragraph. Analytical paragraph is a paragraph that gives descriptive information on the basis of condensed information provided in the given line graph, pie chart, bar diagram, etc. So you will be given an input, a line graph, pie chart, bar diagram, a map, report, etc. So what you have to do is, students, you have to analyze the given data. It means you have to examine the data in detail, which is presented in the form of chart, map, report or graph. Students, writing an analytical paragraph requires an analysis and comparison of the given facts and drawing conclusions based on the given data. So first you have to study the given graph properly. You have to analyze it and then you have to compare the given facts to come to a conclusion. Now students, let's see how to write an analytical paragraph. Analytical paragraph has three main points. First one is introduction. Introduction has to be very, very short. Usually it is written in one or maximum two sentences, not more than that. Here what you have to do is, you simply have to paraphrase the question. The information which is given in the question, that you have to write again but in your own words. Then you have to give the overview. Overview means you have to describe the overall trend of the given graph. And then you have to frame body paragraphs. Here you are going to elaborate your analysis. So here you have to write in detail whatever you have studied and compared from the given graph. Now students, let's see how to write introduction. See, you should start your answer by writing an introduction. The introduction is one or two sentences where you have to paraphrase the information from your question. So these are the lines which would help you to paraphrase your question easy. You may start like this. The pictorial representation reveals the fact that, after that, note down from the question, or you can write the chart shows or the chart reveals, the chart represents, the chart illustrates. So whichever word is used there in the question, you don't have to use that. Pick up some other word. So students, you have to be very clever over here because you are writing the same thing given by the examiner, but you have to use synonyms and change it. You have to write it in your own language. So here you can also write the trends shown describe that, or the bar graph provides information about. Suppose in the question they have written the chart shows dash dash dash. So you can change it and write the bar graph provides information about. So it's very simple to paraphrase the question. These sentences are going to help you a lot. Now students, in bar graph you have to compare the trends. So to make comparisons, you need to know the comparative and superlatives of common adjectives. Here are some examples for you. For example, bad, worse, worst, big, bigger, biggest, good, better, best. So you know when you are comparing, you have to use the comparative degree, that is better when you compare the two things. And comparative degree is always followed by than, better than, bigger than, larger than, higher than. And the superlative is for more than two. And superlative is always preceded with the biggest, the best, the largest, the highest. So more examples are little, less, least, long, longer, longest, low, lower, lowest, many, more, most, or much, more, most in case of uncountables. Now in this slide also there are certain more examples for you. New, newer, newest, old, older, oldest, poor, poorer, poorest, rich, richer, richest, short, shorter, shortest, small, smaller, smallest, strong, stronger, strongest, expensive, more expensive, most expensive. So students, these adjectives would be helpful for you for comparing the data. Now, something more about comparisons. To signal comparisons and contrast within a sentence, you can use the following conjunction. For example, as dash as. So you can write as long as high as good as. Same way, not as dash as. Not so dash as. So in this dash, you have to fill in any adjective. Whereas, but, while, although. And to signal comparison and contrast between sentences, you can use the following words and phrases. For example, however, by contrast, on the other hand, in comparison, as opposed to, compared to, more than, versus, greater than, or less than. This way. Now students, if you have to show any difference, for that you can use the words dissimilarity, variation, inconsistency, or opposing trend. Now students, when analyzing a bar chart, we can't give exact details due to the inaccuracies of the chart. So you can use the following words like around, about, approximately, near about. Now here is a list of some more adjectives which can be used, like steady, gradual, sharp, rapid, steep, slight, dramatic, significant, huge, gigantic, fabulous, massive, considerable, vast, and tremendous. And here you can find some adverbs which qualify the verb which is used after the verb, like steadily, gradually, sharply, rapidly, steeply, slightly, dramatically, significantly, hugely, gigantically, fabulously, massively, considerably, vastly, or tremendously. Now, students, here are some sequence markers, because when you are framing a paragraph, most of the students, they keep on writing then, or next after each sentence. So here are some more words which can make your paragraph look good, like you can use following that, subsequently, former, later, after, previous, prior to, simultaneously, means at the same time, during, while, and before the final sentence, last sentence, you can use finally, overall, or to conclude. Now, students, here are some time phrases. These are also required for writing analytical paragraph. For example, over the next 10 days, or over the next 10 years, over the next century. So you can use it as per your given data. 10 days later, in the following 10 days, aane wale 10 dino mein, the next 10 days show, over the period of, from this to this, between this and this, at the beginning of the period, at the end of the period. So make use of these things, because examiners look for these words when they check your answers. Now, students, here is an example. Study the chart given below, which is the result of the survey conducted in the public schools and government schools of Barnala. This depicts the type of activities the teenagers, that is age 13 to 19 years, are involved during their leisure time, during their free time. Complete the summary in about 120 words. Now, students, this is double bar chart. Here, on x-axis, the activities are given, watching TV, net surfing, cell phone, and friends. And this blue bar shows public schools, teenagers of public schools, and red bar shows teenagers of government schools. And here, the percentage is given. Now, students, you know how to write introduction and the overview. And here, you have to frame two body paragraphs. And for that, I advise you. Here you see, four activities are there. Now, when we study the graph, we can see that in two of the activities, this red bar is longer. And in this net surfing and cell phone, blue bar is longer. And in watching TV and friends, this red bar is longer. So now what we can do is, we can frame body paragraph 1, in which we can take two activities in which this blue bar is longer, that is net surfing and cell phone. And in the second body paragraph, we can compare this watching TV and friends. Now, let's write this paragraph. Now, students, in this slide, this graph is also there in front of you. So, the heading is teenagers and leisure time. Now, let's see how to write the introduction paragraph. So, here we can write, as I gave you this sentence earlier, the given bar graph provides information about the survey results which was conducted in public and government schools in Barnala. The chart shown describes four activities. In bracket, we have named the activities, watching TV, net surfing, cell phone and friends, in which the teenagers spend their leisure time. Now, students, see, if you have, say, six activities, then you can name the activities in the bracket. But if it is seven or more than that, then you need not write here. Then you can only say that the chart shown describes eight different activities. Because writing too many activities doesn't look good. And now in the second paragraph, we are going to write the overview. So this paragraph starts with the word overall. Here we are going to describe the overall trend. Overall, teenagers from public schools spent more of their leisure time in net surfing and talking on cell phones. The government school students spent it in watching TV and talking to their friends. So this is the overall trend. And now we are going to frame two body paragraphs. The first one, here we are using the activities in which this blue bar is longer. Nowadays, the teenagers are more techno-savvy than the children used to be 10 years ago. Most of the children studying in public schools possess their own cell phones because they belong to rich families. So a human touch is to be given. That's why we have written these two lines. Consequently, public school students spent maximum time on net surfing, whereas government school students spent least time on surfing net. So here we have to compare the trends. In bracket, I have written approximately 48% and 8% respectively. Respectively means 48% time is spent by public school students and 8% by government school students. In comparison with government school students, public school students spent more time on cell phones too. So this way we have framed first body paragraph. Now in second body paragraph, we are going to describe the activities where the government school students spent maximum time. So we can start our paragraph like this. On the other hand, the free time spent on watching TV was the maximum by the teenagers of government school, which was around 34% as compared to teenagers of public school who watched TV for near about 26%. The fourth activity, that is friends, illustrates that teenagers studying in government schools spent 23% of their leisure time in talking to friends as opposed to 20% by teenagers of public school. See students, the vocabulary, the words of comparison which I have told you in my previous slides, many of them are used in writing this analytical paragraph. So you must remember those words if you want to frame good analytical paragraph. Now in your exam, your answer should look like this. I have copied the same from the previous slide over here. So I hope you have understood how to write analytical paragraph. Students, now it's homework time. This is an exercise for you. The chart shows the expenditure of two countries on consumer goods in 2010. Analyze the data and draw appropriate inferences in a paragraph of about 100 to 120 words. So, as we wrote the analytical paragraph just now, in the same manner, you are going to analyze this data and then you are going to frame analytical paragraph on your own. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. And for more such videos, kindly subscribe my channel. Please do not forget to press the bell icon for latest updates. And students, if you like this video, don't hesitate to tap the thumbs up button, press the like button, share my video with your friends, and do comment. Thank you very much.